Hi Sagittarius, I'm Anisha. You can write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. To know more about my work, you may visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com. Sagittarians, thank you so much for being so incredibly patient while I was away. I've been traveling, I went for some meditation camps, I explored, I read, I picked up a small project, and I'm really happy and extremely grateful to be back again to be able to share things with you. Reopening the month, which is retrograde till about the 11th of this month, and Mercury during its retrograde speaks about avoiding signing contracts. Try not to pick up a new job during this time, just because the details could be something that may not be clear to you as of now. It's a great time, however, to be looking at the final details. It's a great time to be revisiting the contracts, the situation that you may have been under discussion, under negotiation. It's also a good time to be backing up all your data. Try not to buy something really expensive during this time. And if you must, try and keep all the receipts and the warranties during this time. We have Venus on the 5th that moves into your house of home and your work, Uranus over here. It speaks about a lot of self-love. It speaks about self-care. It speaks about flashes of inspiration that Uranus will bring along with it. It also indicates maybe an absolutely new way of the way that you look at your fitness, the way that you take care of yourself, the food that you consume. Maybe some of you would completely turn vegan. Maybe you'll become very conscious about your health and not just your physical, but even your mental health. Looking at your workplace, maybe putting more structure to it. This also means your day-to-day chores. Maybe you need to be making more time. You need to be prioritizing as to how much time you need to be allocating to what, so that you have plenty of time to be doing things that you enjoy the most. We have a full moon on the 9th that is there in your house of career. So something comes to a fruition. Maybe a project gets completed. Maybe a job gets finished and you're moving on to a next job or to a next project. This full moon also speaks about something that you have been a project which you found to be quite I wouldn't say limiting really, but it could be quite it may have taken a long time to finish, and you're almost sort of glad to see it end now. And this just opens up more doors for you now to explore, Sagittarians. On the 17th, we have the Mercury, which moves into your house of home. And this is the house of Cancer. It also rules your mother, and it resonates with Sun and Neptune over here. So during this time, there can be that, there could be a lot of conversations. Maybe you're looking at moving a house. Maybe you're looking at, there's clarity. Maybe you have an asset which is there, which you need to be selling. In certain cases, you may have your parents come and stay with you, and you could just be, wanting a family. You could be wanting to spend more time with your family and be responsible and take care for them. We have Sun on the 20th that moves into your house of love, romance, creativity, and children. And we also have a new moon. So it's a lovely time, Sagittarians, to be spending time with your children, having those great heart-to-heart conversations, letting the inner child in you. It's also a great time for you to be having a clarity, having some more clarity on a pet project, maybe something that you're really passionate about and you've thought about it for a long time. And this is a time where you will start finally implementing those dreams and creating something out of those dreams. Now, on the 22nd, we have Sun that moves into your house of communication. This is also the house that rules your siblings And then on the 31st, we have Mars that joins Uranus as well into the same house. So I think a lot of you could be speaking your heart out. You could be quite vocal about how you feel and what you think. Some of you could be quite concerned about a sibling, and you could be advising your sibling as well. You could be feeling things. Some of you could be quite involved in your community. Maybe there is something that you are concerned about on the area where you live. Maybe it's a neighborhood. Maybe you want to make it more green, more peaceful, and you could be a part of that group that takes care of these things around your house. It is also a good time to be speaking up. And I think with Mars being over there and with Uranus being the, besides the flashes of inspiration that it gives, it will be, you will quite surprise yourself by, you know, your own forthrightness. So try and not sort of have a foot and mouth problem over here, Sagittarius. Do speak your mind and do speak from the heart. Try and be careful as to how is it that you present the things, lest they be misunderstood. It's been a pleasure speaking with you, Sagittarians, and I'm extremely grateful and I'm thankful again for you for being so patient and for still being over here with me. I look forward to seeing you next month. And